Hey guys, I'm so excited to finally film this video. This is the first lesson out of many of EntermedSchool.com's free IMAT course online. So in this lesson, I'm going to talk about which books are the best to actually study for the IMAT and which books we are going to use during this free IMAT course. I'm going to write on the board all of the books we are going to actually use during this 3 or 4 month period of this IMAT course, which is of course completely free, and I'm so excited to finally film this video. By the way, my name is Ari, I'm the owner of EntermedSchool.com, which I forgot to say because I'm so excited. And I believe everyone needs to have an equal chance to actually get to take the IMAT and to actually know what to do in order to take the IMAT exam. So this lesson is going to be all about books and kind of an introduction to the future. It's going to be a short video. I'm not going to dive in completely into the study materials. We are not going to touch anything yet. Don't forget to subscribe, because in the future I'm going to upload video every day in order to finish this entire free IMAT course before the IMAT exam, so you can study with me and to take the exam and to be prepared completely and to know what to do each day. So this first lesson is going to be just an introduction. I'm going to introduce to you the books I used and which books I recommend to everyone to use to study for the IMAT in the most efficient way. So the IMAT exam is divided into 4 different sections. Each section has the following questions, amount of questions. So the logic has 10 actual critical thinking and problem solving questions according to the list 2018. I still don't know which is the syllabus for 2020, so I'm based on the fact that the IMAT exam is going to have 12 general knowledge like 2019 and 12 general knowledge questions. Biology has 18 questions, chemistry has 12, and math and physics have 8 questions for each usually. For general knowledge, to be honest, I'm not going to suggest you to actually buy and download books and read them entirely, like history and anatomy and Nobel Prizes, and it's a waste of time. What I do going to say is, if you actually want to study efficiently for the general knowledge, you should, based on previous questions of the IMAT, of the BMAT, of a lot of different exams, I will provide you on the EntermedSchool.com's website for free my flashcards, which is made out of many similar exam questions which are being asked for the general knowledge. This is one tip I want to say: don't actually dive in so quickly into the questions, because you're going to find yourself overwhelmed by the amount of material and type of questions are being asked on the IMAT. For critical thinking, I can suggest you to read the Thinking Skills book by Cambridge if you have enough time, or to actually solve a lot of questions. Okay, for logic and critical thinking in general, critical thinking and problem solving, it's called logic. I'm going to provide a full video which is going to give you an idea behind how to actually approach those kind of questions, because if you are going to open the previous IMAT questions, you're just going to be so overwhelmed by the amount of study material and the different kind of questions, and you're not going to know and understand what they are actually asking you to solve. After, I'm going to explain you in several weeks how to actually solve those questions. You will be able to solve a lot of IMAT and BMAT and TSA questions, which of course I'm going to provide you as a practice material. You are not going to have any problems solving those questions. The book I used myself for this subject on the IMAT is called Thinking Skills by Cambridge. I will show a picture of it and I will send a link below. You should actually read it and understand how to solve the questions. But anyway, if you don't have time, I'm just going to provide 7 different types of tricks to actually approach and solve each question. Okay, the most important subjects on the IMAT are biology and chemistry. You should focus on those subjects a lot, and when I'm saying a lot is a lot, much more than practicing critical thinking, much more than practicing general knowledge, and even sometimes much more than practicing math and physics, because Each point on the IMAT gives you 1.5 points if you don't answer it correctly and you have a mistake, it's minus 0.4 points. So you can get 45 points from the 30 questions of the biology and chemistry, but you also get minus 300 points and to lose a lot of points because the biology and chemistry questions are very easy, very fast to answer, very quick to answer, and to be honest, not hard at all if you know how to actually study. So the best books to study for the biology and for the chemistry topics are Pearson's and Cambridge. Personally, I use Pearson's. The books are going through the entire subject. You won't miss anything for the IMAT. And if on top of that you use different books, if you have enough time, like SAT or even Khan Academy, which I will talk about in the future, you're going to be set up for the entire IMAT. But the best books to study for the biology and for the chemistry are Pearson's, period. I used a lot of different, and I tried a lot of different books. No one is even comes close to the level of the Pearson's books, so I'm suggesting you to buy those books and memorize everything by heart. So, to sum it up, for biology and chemistry, I highly suggest you to buy Pearson books. Those are the best books in my opinion, at least. Some people might say differently, but from my experience and from my friends' experience, the Pearson books are the best books to use. The broadest subject on the IMAT is math and physics. For physics, the entire high school syllabus you might or might not actually study before is on the exam. You should memorize a lot of different equations and you should know by heart the concepts of the different study material they suggest on the syllabus. If you don't have any solid base of math, you might want to consider to give it up, math and physics, because the questions aren't hard, but they do require a lot of work. When I'm saying a lot of work, it means you should study an entire book for 8 questions. And if you want to succeed on the IMAT, you should know that some questions that need to be ignored. What do I mean by ignored? You have 100 minutes and there is no way you're going to solve the entire IMAT in 100 minutes. So you need to make a strategy and to actually know which questions you're going to solve. I know my strongest parts are biology and chemistry and physics. So the first thing I did on the IMAT is actually to solve the biology, chemistry, physics, then general knowledge, then critical thinking and problem solving, and then math. Only at the end, when I had like 10 minutes, I kept it for the end and I got like 1.5 from the math and 4 points from the physics, if I remember correctly. So the point is to actually know what to skip. And if you know what to skip, you can focus on studying the main subject you actually can get the most point out of. So, to sum this video up, you have the thinking skills, Pearson biology, Pearson chemistry. For math and physics, you have physics for dummies and math for dummies, and also math and physics by Pearson or Cambridge. And if you have enough time, I highly suggest you to actually buy some SAT books, because the SAT, which is an exam taken in America, is very similar by the trickiness of the questions to the IMAT, and I highly suggest you to use different books for the SAT and to solve practice questions that meant to be practiced on for the SAT. And of course, if you didn't follow me so well, because it's the first video and I'm still practicing to talk in front of the camera, so if you didn't follow me, you should read the description of this video, and I'm going to sum everything up and to explain you by much more details what I was talking about in this video. Thank you so much for joining me for the first lesson. I know the quality is not so good and I need to actually practice to teach in front of the camera and not like I'm used to in front of actual people, because I'm just standing here in an empty room and speaking in front of the camera. Read everything on the website and make sure you understand and make sure you get the big picture of what is going to be expected from you during those following months until September, which is the date of the Anat, and what is going on until this date. Thank you again so much for joining me for this free Anat course journey. If you have any questions, just make sure to enter to my WhatsApp group and go to entermedschool.com, leave a question, or just leave a question below. And make sure to subscribe again, because you're going to be notified each time I'm uploading another IMAT course video. Thank you so much for joining me. See you next time.